In the following slides, we will be discussing body condition management practicalities, key areas for a successful program for your farm. Our intention is to highlight the important roles of the body condition management program and to outline the most important areas to implement it successfully. Why is body condition relevant? Sow robustness. Feeding can modify performance. Sows in both extremes of the body condition spectrum can have their lifetime performance compromised and have an impact on animal welfare. Cost of production is also relevant. Sow feed cost accounts for 1/3 of the weaned pig cost. So, what are the goals? One is to monitor body condition changes during gestation and adjust individual feed level needs accordingly. And two, to have at least 90% of the sows farrowing in ideal body condition. What does a successful body condition management program look like? One, it's the combination of five key areas of management, and to make sure that each one of those are properly executed. The absence of one or more areas could jeopardize both quality and consistency of implementation and expected outcome. It's important to review the body condition of the females that are part of your weekly breeding group. It is important to note that the caliper is not intended to be used on gilts at breeding, and bigger gilts should not be fed below the base feed requirement. Create a gilt HNS or heat nose serve flow that allows to breed 90% of the gilts that are between 300 and 350 pounds and on their second heat. Do not breed your at-risk sows when weaned if possible. Skip a heat if they are a P3 or younger, and consider culling if they are a P4 or older. Monitor due to farrow sows that are in recovery or thin measures. Please ask your account manager if you do not have an updated sticker for your caliper. If breeding targets are met, also avoid breeding sows that have other underlying conditions, such as returned one or two times, greater than a P6, poor farrowing performance, or a longer wean-to-service interval. Organizing the weaning area and breeding row based on body condition is key for a high-quality implementation. Place your gilts and thin sows all together in your weaning and breeding area. That will facilitate the execution of proper wean-to-service interval management, subsequent body condition assessment, feeder adjustment, feeding time stress, and body condition recovery of thin females. An objective assessment should be performed across gestation to monitor body condition changes so you can adjust individual feeding levels. We do this at entry at farrowing, weaning, and 30 days or when creating groups. To place the caliper in the right position on the back of the sow, first, touch the last rib with your finger. Second, place the caliper on the back of the sow at the last rib. Here's a tip. We suggest marking with permanent marker the caliper placement on the back when measuring, or find a system that works better for you and your farm to track progress at farrowing, weaning, 30 days, or when creating groups. Here's an image of our body condition targets. Recovery or undercondition, there should be none at farrowing. Target or ideal body condition, as many as possible. And at-risk or over-conditioned sows, there should be none at weaning. Below is a recommendation. Feel free to use a marking system that works best for your farm. Use visual marks to record body condition assessment on the back of the females after each assessment. For example, one dot equals thin recovery, two dots ideal, three dots at risk. The best time to perform a body condition assessment is first thing in the morning when dropping feed in gestation. This should be performed with two technicians, one for body condition assessment and the other to adjust individual feed boxes immediately after assessment. Feeder setup is crucial for feed efficiency and maintaining ideal body condition. Set up each feeder based on nutritional needs by body condition provided by your nutritionist. Organizing breeding and gestation rows by body condition will help to facilitate the feeder adjustment process. It's important to calibrate your feeders regularly to provide the right setup. For more information on how to calibrate a feed box, visit PIC.com under Resources and search for Feed Box Calibration Tool. This tool was developed to help ensure that the gestation feed box settings correspond with the amount of feed that should be dropped. Weigh feeders at least once a quarter or when changing a diet formulation. If there are different types of feed boxes, you should obtain weights for all the types. Make sure your feed boxes are aligned and consider excessive level of water in troughs to avoid diluting feed when dropped. Here are some key takeaways. Do not feed over-conditioned gilts under base nutritional requirements. Weigh and calibrate feeders at least once a quarter. The continuous training of employees is essential to a successful farm. And do not use calipers on gilts at breeding. These are general recommendations, and we encourage the production staff to follow the farm protocols. Farms should have procedures created and approved by their production management head.